What's up, y'all? Here to break down a lot of concepts and stuff and controversy. Not really controversy, but issues dealing with particular styles that I help bring out. Let's start with threads. You know, threading is from Boogie. There was no B-boys doing threads and needle and thread type moves. It was the Boogie Boys. And a Boogie Boy is a B-boy that started popping. We didn't know what popping was. Boogie essentially is popping with the bounce, popping with the B-boy flavor. So you saw a lot of B-boys that left breaking in 1978, went into MCing or went into writing and went into other things. We just quit. I was one of them cats. And when popping came out in New York, there was a particular squad of people in the Bronx that called it Boogie, and we did it with a B-boy flavor. Now the Boogie Boys were the ones coming out with these concepts, trying to copy shit off of the Soul Train and all that, and we came out with a thing called the thread, and you would see us do this one, you know, all of this these type of threading moves. Then you saw me do the famous one like this, you know. These are things that me, Fable, Loose, well, not really Loose Boost, but my crew, Electric Company, Electric Force, was messing around with. And eventually I learned how to do a track two floor track, which track two was like a scientist on the floor, man. It was very intricate. And when I learned this particular floor track, the way he did it, dropped the one knee, hit the pose, and then flip and do the twist. Every time I hit the pose, I grabbed my foot automatic. The foot just went through naturally. It was my natural motion from Boogie. The foot went through. This practice took place with me, Powerful Pex. You could put the year because it was before he was a New York City breaker. People don't know, they were floor masters, and I used to hang out with Pex a lot. And Pex used to roll with me in Fable before he was a New York City breaker. We all just hung out a lot. We went to Toronto together before he became a New York City breaker, because me, Fable, and Pex had a show out there. And we flew out there with some cat, put us up in a hotel. And in that hotel, we started experimenting with these type of moves. It was Pex's idea for me to put more Boogie into my breaking. They all knew I could break. And that move came out. And we also did another training during the Kennedy Center Honors when he became a New York City breaker. Me and Pex was still hanging out. And me and Pex was training in the room and put together more moves, you know. But that was the main move. The other move was kick worms and all the worm combinations, you know what I mean? Me and Pex again, and Fable. Fable was always there. Mostly doing floor tracks because that became like a little thing I can hit a lot with breaking. We did a floor track. We did a kick worm and flipped into a floor track. Then I did a sweep, kick worm, floor track. And that was another concept me and Pex put together, always in combinations. Everything we did, the original B-Boys worked in combos. So we did that, and we started adding worms and kick worms into my breaking. As far as the Spideman footwork really was not really my idea. It was something that Legs did in the battle, and it was him. After they did the movie Beat Street, there was some kind of beef or something, so they set up a battle with Lee from Beat Street, Joe Swift, I think it was Joe Swift, one of his partners, versus Kudiaki and Legs. I went, it was at a club in the Bronx called First Class, and Legs and Kudiaki showed up, and they put the smack down on them, and that's when Legs did that spider, which is just a regular spider moving to a back row. He did it in a sweet little combination, and that's where I got the idea. I always did spiders. I always would put spider in my breaking, but when I saw him do that, I said, wow, that was sick. So I did the same thing he did, boom, boom, except I went like this. And then little by little, I started doing footwork, and I would put my hand in the placement of a spider, and that's the spider move, and I would roll the leg out. And you will see in a lot of my breaking, back in the days, I'm always hitting that spider pose, and I'm rolling my leg out. Then I started crossing it and doing it this way. And then I started hitting more intricate spider freezes where I would just put my hand in all these different places. It's in a lot of my footage. And you can see when I'm doing it, it's not really a move like other people are doing. It was just part of a style. Now, let me explain. You know, I'm not no B-boy pioneer. back in the 70s, I was a so-so b-boy, below level. You know, I never claimed to be no great b-boy in the 70s. I was just a little Spanish kid that can break. I learned how to break more from black b-boys than I did from Latin. So you can see in my style, my swagger, it's more on that side, you know. I wasn't a six-step kid. I never learned the six-step till Mr. Freeze taught me in 81. My footwork was strictly kickouts and Russians and knee rocks and shit like that. And you can see my footwork was never really complete. So all of that stuff built up to my style. You can see how it came together. I couldn't really complete a full six step and look cool. My shit looked whack. So I would just kick out in the middle of my six steps. And all of these things added to the flow. And when you see a lot of the cats young today, they kind of doing that same flow and that flavor. I never threw these moves because it was during the power move, air move era. So if I did it in a cypher, they would laugh. They would make fun of me. So what I would do is I would go to Roseland, Studio 54, or Funhouse, or the Roxy. And whenever they would do a cypher, you know, I would mix boogie and I would go into breaking and I would do what we call a triple threat. A triple threat is when you can pop, lock, and break. Me, Mr. Freeze, even Sugar Pop would do this. We would do it all in one solo, pop, lock, and break. And that's when I would do a lot of these moves back in the early 80s. But in the mid 80s, I was still performing when everybody quit. So I'm doing shows on Broadway and I'm mastering all these techniques. By the time the 90s came, you could see I'm nailing all of this shit, you know, and it's on tape. I had perfected it. You know, you got to remember, I trained with Fast Break, early 80s, Powerful Pexter. I trained with Rocksteady. I trained with, you know, Watching Legs and Kenny, how they put together combinations. One of my biggest influences was Little Lep teaching me sweep combinations and fakies, how to fake directions. You know, Lep sat with me all night at the PAL in my block in the Bronx, showing me how to fake out, how to do fakies, you know, misdirections. And, you know, Lep was a lot more intricate back then, so I picked up a lot of stuff from Lep. Freeze is the one that introduced me to Little Lep. And of course, Mr. Freeze, also a cat that did the same thing I did, but he was doing hammers into breaking moves. He was ticking in and out of breaking moves. You know, Freeze was doing the same thing I was doing, different flavor, you know. And, you know, that's just basically how it all came together. A lot of the stuff wasn't called origami. It was basically boogie boy shit, you know, electric boogie dancers mixing breaking with boogie.